Hello friends, myself Professor Lau Patel from LJIET Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the lecture series of subject Special Purpose Vehicle, and we are in continuing with chapter 3, that is Constructional Working Features and Instrumentation or Earth Moving Machinery. So we have discussed so many types of special purpose vehicles that are having different functions, working applications and advantages and disadvantages. So in today's lecture we will see about three special purpose vehicles, that how it can work in special operational task. First, that is my bulldozer, in which we will see about the different types of blades or loading buckets that we are using for bulldozer. Second one, that is the forklift. So in the forklift we will see about its constructional and working features, and also it is very important topic for examination purpose, that how forklift is going to work, working features, applications and its design consideration. And the third one, special purpose vehicle, that is my road roller. So in road roller we will see about its function and different types of road rollers that we are currently using in constructional sites. So let us begin with the first topic, that is our bulldozer. So normally you have seen bulldozers in day-to-day life, but for these kind of bulldozer we are only having that it is considered of, it is having a large blade at its front end, which will be operated with the help of hydraulic rams or the hydraulic cylinders. Also we can say that the frontal blade that can be operated with the help of hydraulic rams can be moved towards move to upward direction and downward direction. So the bulldozer, or the main function of the bulldozer, that is to excavate the soil, whether it is light, medium or very hard kind of soil. So for that purpose we are using bulldozers. So the bulldozers can either be wheel operated or crawler operated. So this is a basic diagram of bulldozer, in which you will find driver cabin, which from that he can control the overall bulldozer and its tasks. Moving further, let us see about the function and working features. So we can say that it is a large motorized machine that can travel on track. Also we can say that if you are choosing wheel type, so it can also travel on wheels also. Also we can see that the bulldozer, that is equipped with a metal blade at front. So from that blade we can push the materials, like what are the materials? Soil, sand, snow, rubble, rock. So these are the materials that can be transferred with the help of bulldozers at construction site or conventional work purposes. The second point, that is we can say that bulldozers are also known as crawlers, because if we are choosing continuous track type, so for that case we can say crawlers. So when needed, a hook like device which can be called ripper, that can also be mounted on my bulldozer. So bulldozer is universally used nowadays, and for different operation you can choose a different device or attachment to the main dozers. Third one, that is we can say that bulldozer can be found on a wide range of sites, like everywhere you will find the basic dozer or bulldozers, like different sites, mines, quarries, military base, heavy industrial factories, engineering projects, farms. So there are wide applications for bulldozers. Also the word bulldozer, that refers to only tractor fitted with dozer blade. If you find any farm, like the tractor is having frontal bucket, that is also called as dozers. So these are the main points of bulldozer and how it is going to work, that we have already discussed in previous special purpose vehicle. Now moving further to the types of blade. See, there are several types of blade that are going to use depending upon the applications or operations of the special purpose vehicle. So let us see one by one. First blade, that is the S blade, that we can also call it straight blade. So for straight blade we can say that it is not having any lateral arm or lateral curve throughout the blade. Also there are no side wings for that particular blade. Also we can say that this kind of blade is going to use to straighten up the road or leveling purpose. Also we can use this kind of blade to remove the materials or remove the scrap materials from one place to another place. ultimately we can say that this kind of blade that can be used not for loading or unloading purpose. This is for pushing or to clean the surface area. Second one, that is the U-type blade, that is called universal blade. So in the universal blade, compared with S blade, it is very good in quality. Also it can load a few amount of, or we can say the large amount of materials, and it can transport from one place to another place or one place to another special purpose vehicle. Construction wise we can say that these kind of blade is having lateral or side wings to support the extra or loose materials. Also at the end of blade you will find teeth or sharp edges to excavate the area at certain depth. We can also operate these bucket with the help of hydraulic ramps. So with the help of ramps we can do the motion, upward motion and downward motion with the help of hydraulics. Also at certain degree the bucket can be rotated counterclockwise or clockwise direction to load and unload the material to another special purpose vehicle. The third and the last one type, that is SU blade, that is called a semi-universal blade. So semi-universal blade can be in between the S blade and U blade. So we can say that it is neither straight or nor universal blade. So it is for middle purpose only. Also we can say that it is for light and medium soil surfaces. So you cannot use this kind of blade in hard surfaces. Also the excavation quality is not that much up to U blade. So the universal blade is in general use. So these are the different three kinds of blade that has been attached with my dozers or any kind of loaders. Now let us see about the forklift. See, this is the basic diagram of forklift. The construction wise we can see that the first number, that is the overhead guard. So it is the safety for the driver. Second, that is the counterweight. We all know that forklift is going to load several or huge amount of load onto its bucket. So for safety purpose, or we can put the counterweight to balance the loading and unloading condition. Also we can say that it is either engine operated or battery operated. So the engine compartment or battery compartment can be mounted under the seat area. Fourth, that is the operator cap, from which the operator can ride or control the loading and unloading. Next, the steer axle. Fifth point, that you can see the rear axle, that is the steer axle, to easily control the vehicle or to turn the vehicle very sharply or in a very compact area, we are choosing rear wheel drive. So the steer axle will be on rear. Next one, sixth one, that is the drive axle. So the drive axle or live axle, that is at our frontal area, for which it can easily load the materials. 11th point, that is the mast. Mast, that is the one kind of bell from which the fork can be motion with reference to the motion, upward motion and downward motion. Also the upward and downward motion can be done with the help of hydraulic cylinder or tilt cylinder. See, in some kind of forklift we are selecting either pulley or chain type mechanism also, with compared with hydraulic cylinders. Also the forks that has been attached, so the forks can be moved towards frontal, forward, backward, upward motion, downward motion and also the sideways. So these are the basic construction of forklift. Let us see about its function. Like it is a kind of mini truck that can be lift and transfer the load. So we know that this kind of special purpose vehicle that can be used in very compact area or small or for industrial premises. So the application of the forklift, that is like warehouse, as I have said, that the lots of luggage or boxes or pallets that can be transferred from one place to another place. So most of the boxes are in warehouse or storage area. Second one, that is the industrial premises. For the final product or manufacturing product we are using forklift. The manufacturing units, dock yards or shipyards, from which the container should be transferred from one place to another place. Also the construction site. So these are the applications at which we are choosing forklift. Now let us see about the working principle. Like, it is very high demand because it is small in size, also it is having good loading capacities and it can transport within industrial premises. Also it is very safe vehicle, different power source. As I have said, it can be operated either by IC engine or electrical or CNG also. There are two parts. First is to lift the load, and second one, that is keep the forklift down. So for that we have counterweight. Also there is a hydraulically operated mast to move, raise, lower and lift the forklift, as I have discussed in figure. So the counterweight has been at rear side. Let us see about the loading capacities. Like, if we are choosing electric forklift, that it has 2600 pound loading capacity, that is almost 1200 to 1400 kg, and at a certain height of 111 inch height. So that means around 9.25 feet it can load certain amount, it can load certain amount of materials or final product. Now let us see about its working, like how it is going to work. So for that we have a video in which several controllers that is with driver, so it can easily operate. So from the several levers it can, the forklift can be easily lifted upward and downward. Also the tilted mechanism is there with the mast, and for that mast it can easily downward or upward my overall fork movement. So here you can see the different motion which can be performed with the help of forklift. See here, it can be very easy to lift such kind of manage load, or simply we can say that for boxes or pallets it is very useful to have forklift in industries. So it is very easy to use and very compact in size, so we can say that it is very advantageous for lifting the load as well as transporting the load. Now third and the last topic, that is road rollers. So we have seen many road rollers and we have now few points about it. Like, it is used for compaction of soil, so pressurize the soil, gravel, sand, crust, stone layers. So road rollers can be used to make a new road with the help of compaction or impact loading. Also the main principle, that is vibration, impact loading and applying direct pressure. So these operations can be done with the help of road rollers. See the basic diagram or figure that has been shown in the figure, like at the frontal portion or at the rear portion. If you are choosing one roller or two roller, depending upon the application you can choose. So there are number of rollers that can be attached at the bottom portion, and from that portion we are choosing these road roller for leveling purposes. See, there are several types of road rollers are there. First, that is vibratory road roller. So the vibratory road roller, in which we can see that the frontal portion of the roller that has been oscillated with the help of motors. So the oscillation might be very slightly, so you cannot see properly, but the vibration is there. So for proper air removal from the soil we are using vibratory road rollers. The second type, that is the tamping or shift foot road rollers, in which you will find the road roller that is having shift foot surface or such kind of material, so it can easily pressure to my soil or soft soil. The third one, that is the smooth wheel rollers, in which we are using different kind of wheels, and it can level or smoothen the road or surfaces. And the fourth one, that is the pneumatic tire rollers, in which we are choosing different tires for frontal portion as well as the rear portion. So this is all about the third chapter. We have discussed few special purpose vehicles, and from next lecture we will discuss about the mobile cranes from the fifth chapter. So that is all for today's lecture. Thank you.